In this video, we will discuss about sample size correction. This video is a continuation of sample size calculation for estimation of population mean video. I am giving the link for this video in the description. You can see the video where we have discussed about calculating sample size using a formula. This is a formula: n is equal to sigma square into z square divided by d square. Now we'll see the example. In that video, we have calculated sample size is 385, and if population size is 3000, I'm saying a case, if population size is 3000, then what is happening? Sample size is greater than or equal to 10% of the population size. Then the sample size need to be corrected. This correction is called finite population correction. Finite population correction to sample size NC is equal to small n into capital N divided by capital N plus small n minus 1, where capital N is population size, small n is sample size. Now the population size, we have said it to be 3000. Sample size we have calculated as 385. Now substitute in that equation and calculate. We are going to get that finite population correction to sample size is 341. Calculated sample size is 385. Corrected sample size is 341. So we are reducing sample size by 44. Why the sample size got reduced from 385 to 345? Because the sample size is greater than or equal to 10% of the population size. So we did finite population correction and reduce the sample size from 385 to 341. Now we will discuss the second condition, re-estimating precision level. The sample size is calculated as 385. Using this formula, n is equal to sigma square into z square divided by d square. The population standard deviation is taken as $100. Confidence interval is 95%. Z value is 1.96. Precision level as a $10. See, the population standard deviation may not be actual value. It is assumed estimation which you are considering as $100. Now after sample size is determined, collect the data and now calculate what is the sample standard deviation. For example, the sample standard deviation is 90. Now the condition applies. If population estimated standard deviation is not equal to sample standard deviation, what is population estimated standard deviation? We have estimated as $100. But what is sample standard deviation we are getting? 90. Then there is a difference. Population estimated standard deviation is not equal to sample standard deviation. We need to re-estimate the precision level. Now this is a formula where we are going to use for revised precision level, z into s divided by square root of n. Z is 1.96, s is equal to 90, n is equal to 385. Now substitute in the equation, we get DC as 8.990. Approximately it is 9. So this is a revised precision level. 9 is revised precision level. The assumed precision level as a 10 means what happened? The precision level is reduced. You can see the estimated precision level, that is maximum permissible difference, is 10 we have assumed, but revised precision level is 9. Why? Because the revised precision level is less than actual planned precision level, because the population standard deviation is overestimated. We have estimated as 100, but the sample standard deviation was only 90. So there was a difference in sample standard deviation and population standard deviation. So now consider the population standard deviation as 90 and the precision level as 9. So this is how we re-estimate the standard deviation as well as the precision level.